Embarking on a new era of maritime prowess, forthcoming aircraft carriers promise to redefine naval capabilities globally. These mighty vessels at the forefront of naval innovation boast advanced technologies and strategic designs. These behemoths represent the next frontier in naval power. As nations invest in these floating fortresses, the seas anticipate the arrival of vessels that will shape the future of naval warfare. Join us as we explore the impressive and diverse world of the 10 future aircraft carriers. Fujian or Type 003. She is a second-generation aircraft carrier currently under construction for the People's Liberation Army Navy. Launched on June 17, 2022, it represents China's inaugural fixed-wing aircraft carrier with a fully indigenous design, incorporating a cattle bar system and electromagnetic catapults. The carrier size is anticipated to mirror that of the incomplete 85,000-ton Soviet aircraft carrier Yulnovsk and the 100,000-ton supercarriers of the United States Navy. Analyst Robert Farley in 2019 asserted that the Type 003 could potentially be the largest and most advanced aircraft carrier ever constructed outside the United States. By April 2023, the third carrier commenced power and mooring trials, with sea trials slated for 2024. Notably, in November 2023, the carrier initiated testing of its onboard electromagnetic catapult system. The Type 004. She is a planned supercarrier within the People's Liberation Army Navy's aircraft carrier program. It is envisioned as an advancement over the preceding Type 003 carrier, sharing the inclusion of an integrated electric propulsion system for the operation of electromagnetic catapults. Distinguished by its significantly larger size, the Type 004 is poised to become the first Chinese carrier equipped with nuclear marine propulsion. This advancement is expected to provide ample electric power, potentially facilitating the deployment of emerging technologies such as laser weapons and railguns currently in development. Anticipated aircraft complements for the Type 004 include J-15 and J-31 fighters, Xi'an KJ-600 airborne early warning and control aircraft, anti-submarine warfare aircraft, and stealth attack drones. The CVX aircraft carrier. This is a proposed class of aircraft carriers intended for the Republic of Korea Navy. It is designed to accommodate both fixed-wing and rotary-wing operations, departing from the traditional amphibious assault roles of the preceding Dokdo class. Notably, the CVX will forego a well deck for amphibious assault craft, opting instead to allocate internal space for aircraft storage and maintenance. The axial design of the flight deck sets it apart from the ski jump configuration. An interesting feature is the inclusion of two islands, distinguishing the CVX as one of the few aircraft carriers globally with this characteristic. The PANG. The commencement of the construction of the next generation aircraft carrier PANG is anticipated around 2031, with sea trials slated to commence in approximately 2035. It is projected to be commissioned into service by 2038, coinciding with the retirement of the Charles de Gaulle aircraft carrier. PANG will be propelled by nuclear power and will incorporate the electromagnetic aircraft launch system catapult. Preliminary design work for the naval 220MW K-22 nuclear reactors will propel the vessel, was concluded in 2023. In terms of self-defense mechanisms, the PANG model showcases various features, including SIMBAT RC, Rapid Fire CIWS, Vertical Launch System VLS for Aster missiles, and innovative CMLS anti-torpedo decoy launchers. INS Vishal. Also referred to as Indigenous Aircraft Carrier 3, this is a prospective aircraft carrier intended for construction by Cochin Shipyard Limited to augment the Indian Navy's capabilities. The envisioned design for this class represents a significant changes from Vigrant, incorporating notable modifications such as increased size and displacement. There is contemplation of incorporating an electromagnetic aircraft launch system catabar system. Anticipated to be commissioned into service in the early 2030s, INS Vishal's carrier air wing is envisioned to include HAL TED BF and the naval variant of HAL AMCA. Naval strategies are considering the integration of UCAVs, fixed-wing ASW and AEW&C aircraft, as well as medium and light fighters to enhance operational versatility. The Project 23000E or STORM. This is a conceptual aircraft carrier designed by the Krylov State Research Center for the Russian Navy. The estimated cost for the export variant surpasses US$5.5 billion, and as of 2017, the development timeline was projected to span a decade. This carrier is being assessed as a potential replacement for the Admiral Kuznetsov, commissioned in 1991, within the Russian Navy's Northern Fleet. Russian authorities have expressed plans to initiate the construction of a new heavy aircraft carrier between 2025 and 2030. In 2020, there were reports suggesting that, if constructed, the carrier might also incorporate the proposed S-500 surface-to-air missile system. The USS John F. Kennedy CVN-79. This is the second aircraft carrier of the Gerald R. Ford class, currently under construction for the United States Navy. Launched on October 29, 2019 and christened on December 7, 2019, this nuclear-powered aircraft carrier incorporates several enhancements compared to the original Ford class design. Notable improvements include modifications to the flight deck, a redesigned island, and upgraded weapons handling systems aimed at enhancing operability, efficiency, and reducing manpower requirements. Additionally, the CVN-79 features a new nuclear power plant, improved compatibility with future technologies, and an upgraded electrical power generation capacity. The ship has undergone testing with the electromagnetic aircraft launch system and its combat system. Anticipated for delivery in 2025, the U.S. John F. Kennedy represents a significant advancement within the Gerald R. Ford class. The USS Enterprise CVN-80. This stands as the third aircraft carrier within the Gerald R. Ford class to be commissioned for the United States Navy. This vessel, the ninth in the U.S. Naval Fleet and the third carrier to bear the name Enterprise, initiated its construction with a steel-cutting ceremony in August 2017, with the intent to replace the USS Dwight D. Eisenhower. The USS Enterprise is set to be launched in November 2025, with an anticipated delivery date of March 2028. Constructed by Huntington Ingalls Industries Newport News Shipbuilding in Newport News, Virginia, CVN-80 holds the distinction of being the first aircraft carrier entirely conceived and built through digital platforms. Positioned to advance naval warfare capabilities, the forthcoming USS Enterprise is poised to set new standards within the field. USS Doris Miller CVN-81. She is slated to become the fourth aircraft carrier in the Gerald R. Ford class for the United States Navy. The construction timeline outlines plans to commence laying down the vessel in January 2026, followed by a launch in October 2029, and ultimately commissioning in 2032. Newport News Shipbuilding, a division of Huntington Ingalls Industries, will undertake the construction of the USS Doris Miller. This carrier represents the second tribute to Miller, the decorated recipient of the Navy Cross for his bravery during the Pearl Harbor attack, with the first being the USS Miller FF-1091. Positioned as a centerpiece in the nation's security strategy, the USS Doris Miller is designed to play a crucial role in safeguarding global sea lanes and supporting the protection of the worldwide economy. The CVN-82. The designation for CVN-82 within the Gerald R. Ford class has not been determined. The U.S. Navy intends to conduct a comprehensive analysis of the future carrier force, including the configuration of the planned CVN-82. As of now, the carrier is in the planning phase and has not yet entered the construction stage. To our audience, we invite your input. What or for whom should this next carrier aircraft CVN-82 be named and why? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. If you appreciate the content, please do help us reach a wider audience by sharing this video. Thank you for your viewership. Until next time, goodbye.